Why do I choose to do this work? Nothing is more interesting. Nothing is more rewarding.
It's my life passion, really.
I think it's an immense privilege.
There's nothing more gratifying than protecting human rights.
More than 60 years ago now, there was a uniform global commitment to the universal values of human rights.
This has been an enormous accomplishment, to have human rights now a common issue.
You know, we have over the last 25 years seen both a proliferation of treaties and conventions and a lot of governments ratifying them, which is lays the foundation, but it's only a foundation.
And this is one of the challenges that we face, is making human rights real to people in their daily lives.
This need to move beyond conventions is really a need to realize that human rights aren't just a legal issue. They're a market issue, they're a technical issue, and they're a social issue.
It used to be that you almost had to be a lawyer or a law student to do human rights work. Now it's no longer the case.
We're living in an era where the politics of fear and anger have been devastating to the success and to the progress we've made.
Nós estamos condenados a agir. Nós não temos alternativa.
It requires new ways of thinking about economic structures. It requires new ways of thinking about the place of certain groups within society.
The more the human rights arena is connected to everyday movements for human dignity, I think that that's where you'll find the magical opportunities.
It's no longer possible to talk about human rights in one country alone. Anything that happens in any part of the world impacts everyone else.
And because we now have more democratic means of communication, at least those with access to technology do, the infection, the wonderful, glorious infection of the idea of human rights is spreading.
You know, I hear this all the time, that, you know, aren't human rights just a Western imposition?
If you ask people who are in jails in China or in Iran or Saudi Arabia, they're not going to talk about it as a Western concept.
The desire for freedom is part of the human condition.
In order for the human rights movement to succeed in the 21st century,
we need more leaders that represent the directly affected communities, especially from the Global South.
We have to learn how to listen to those who are being marginalized.
We need governments to implement the commitments they have made under the conventions.
To recommit themselves to the basic principles that haven't changed since 1948.
We need more grassroots activism for social justice.
There has to be a reordering of the whole world.
And every day I know change is necessary.
Ultimately, change will have to come from the people themselves. And that is always inspirational.
I have seen with my own eyes and have been a part of the very change that I hoped to see come.
And it's one of our challenges to imagine things, to see things that we haven't seen manifest yet, but we know are essential to human rights.
If you look 50 years forward, we want human rights a normal part of governance. We want it to be just the expectation as to how governments behave.
So that one day there'll be somebody sitting here being interviewed like me, and someone like you will be questioning. And we won't be able to believe that there was ever a time. We'll be saying to each other, oh, that can't be true, when these rights weren't understood as natural and organic and part of being a human being.